Hi there, Chris here, another quick tip for you all. In this video, we are going to continue our look at painting Rodigus, the Great Unclean One. And so as you can see here, we are nearing completion. We're getting to smaller details now on this guy, and we have this great collection of pustules on that leg there. And so we're going to do something a little bit creepy for that space. Dryad Bark is going to be our first color here. And basically, we're going to color in each of the little baubles, as it were. One of them kind of looks like it's busted open, and so we'll color that one as well. But otherwise, we're going to go around and just pick out each one in this Dryad Bark, giving us a nice deep dark brown tone. And you may notice that we have left one of them alone, and that's on purpose because we're going to come back to that one later. So we have our Dryad Bark down there, and next we're going to come in with some Mournfang Brown. This is a nice light brown, has a bit of a warmer quality to it, a bit of an orange kind of quality, which is fine. And as we lay this color down, we're going to apply this on the lower half of each of those little pustules. Basically, we're going to color each one like a diamond or a gemstone, how we build up the color downwards. So we have the deeper color above, and we have the brighter color building downwards. So as you guessed it, kind of spoiler, we're going to do these little guys as little gemstones, basically. So next, once we have that color down, we're going to take some Averland Sunset. We're going to slap this onto the palette, mix it into our Mournfang Brown in a slightly 1-to-1 mix ratio, roughly, of course. And basically, we are going to apply a slight crescent to each of those little pustules. And we're going to probably lay down two layers of this down because, again, when we put the first layer down, it's not quite as dark because, again, I have the color thinned out just ever so slightly. And so I will have to apply another layer of it. And, of course, I apply another layer on about the 6 o'clock or 7 o'clock position. If you're thinking of like a clock face, that's basically where I'm laying the brighter color downwards. And as you can see here, I'm just simply working my way through and applying the second little layer down. Again, you can see how the next color, next layering is a lot brighter. And then here I'm just applying some of the color inside that broken pustule. I know, gross. Once that is dry, we're going to come in with a little bit more Averland Sunset. And basically, we're going to do the same thing, except, of course, when we are applying these highlights, and I'm using my detail brush here, we are trying to remain quite small in the area in which we're picking out. And so, again, it's very, very minimal. It's like almost like a little dash, but it's more like a small crescent shape. But, you know, again, it's really kind of however you can manage to apply that small little amount of color. We're not looking for a huge amount there. We're just looking to just really kind of start really brightening that area up. Once that's done, we're going to come in with Urial Yellow. And this is going to be just a tiny little dot in those areas on each of the little pustules where the brightest amount of light has gathered in each of those little pustules. Again, we're doing this just like we do gemstones. And so if you've ever done the gemstone look where you paint the illusion of transition or translucency in an object, this is pretty much what we're doing here. And we want to have these pustules kind of look like they're kind of clear and they're just ready to pop. And actually, one has already popped. And I know, it's very, very gross. Next is a Screaming Skull. And this is going to be our little spot highlight on each of the little points. Normally we do this with white, but I figured Screaming Skull, we can do it. It kind of gives us a bit of a subdued kind of look. It's not quite as harsh as using white. It's pretty close, but again, it just, you know, gives us a little bit of more of a subdued kind of look. And I was actually quite pleased with it, and actually keeps it more of a fleshier feeling in the areas. And then while we have the Screaming Skull out, I'm going to cover this little pustule right here. Well, it used to be a pustule, but now it's not. Now it's going to be something else. I'm going to go for something kind of weird, kind of disturbing. Pallid Witch Flesh is next. And basically what we're going to do is here, we're going to apply this in a little highlight fashion. So basically, I'm just going to put a semicircular highlight on the top of that high point on the bauble. And it gives us a nice bright point to work from. Next, I'm going to come in with some Caliban Green, and I think you guys might have guessed it by now what I'm going to do. I'm going to put a little circle here, right in through the middle of it. And already, I think you guys can guess what it is. That's right, we're putting an eyeball in here. There's a little eyeball busting out from this little collection of pustules. Why? Who knows? But we're doing it. Wah Flesh is next. You can mix a little bit of Wah Flesh into your Caliban Green and get a 50-50 mixture of it and apply it. And I think that's pretty much what we did here. I just took a little bit of the Caliban Green and applied it. And it's pretty much like man, it's like 5/8 of the surface of that Caliban green that I lay this mixture down. And then I'll come in with the wall flesh and start laying the highlights, and it's about halfway through the eye, and I concentrate more of the color. I'm drawing little dashes indicating like the iris of the eye. You know, the eye kind of has that slight little texture to it. And so basically that's what we're doing here. We're basically going to start laying these colors down. I'm going to throw some warp stone glow onto the palette, and basically we're going to do the exact same thing here. We're going to start laying down just a little bit more dashes as we build up the highlights. And of course I'm kind of working the brush, flicking in towards the center. So I'm allowing some of that color to build up, because really I want the sharp points on the outer points of the iris itself. And so again, I'm not too worried about building the color up through the center. I'm more worried about along that outer edge of the iris, so that it kind of has that indication of that texture going on. And of course I did mix a little bit of the wall flesh into the Caliban green or Warpstone glow beforehand, and then did another layering. Moot green is next, and again, we're just gonna throw a little bit here. Again, we're creating little dashes, and this is along the bottom portion of the iris. Again, when we're doing irises, it is kind of like how we do the gemstone effect, so we're building the color downwards and keeping the deeper colors above, and that gives us that impression of that iris in there. Once we're happy with that, we're gonna come in with some Abaddon Black. This is for the pupil. And basically we're just gonna thin this color out just ever so slightly and apply a tiny little dot right in there. Just very, very carefully create a little circle. Again, if you have the color thinned out just ever so slightly, it's pretty straightforward to lay that little dot down. Then next, we're gonna take some white scar. We're just gonna throw a little bit onto our palette, and this is gonna be for the little spot highlights on top of the iris and the pupil itself, because technically those do cast highlights. Because there's a little bump there on the pupil, if you ever look at an eyeball. But anyway, as you can see, just throw a little highlights in there, and again, it gives us that impression of a real kind of eyeball. Next, we're going to take some corn red, thin it out just ever so slightly, sticking with our detail brush, and basically we're going to draw on just a couple little veins, basically just like creating little Ys, like the letter Y. Just creating little Ys there, just to give us the impression of veins. Carbon Crimson is next, and very carefully we're going to apply this to the base of the eyeball, just giving us that hint of the redding around the eye, because we do have, like, you know, the veins appearing as well. And that will be it. That is the eyeball. Something a little bit creepy for our models, just a different idea, something to have fun with, but that's it. It's as easy as that. Well, I hope you found that quick tip useful and informative. You can watch another quick tip today on miniwargaming.com's Vault. Just click on the link in the video description below to watch it right now. If you're not already a Vault member, you can sign up for a free 7-day trial. Be sure to sign up for the Silver membership, and that will give you instant access to over 1,000 painting tutorials already in our Vault. And again, thank you for watching, commenting, and subscribing, and happy wargaming.